Hello, today's video is on our stock number 32681ND Gearhead motor with an attached lead screw. Give you a nice video to show you the basic layout, how you see the size of it in reference to the 1-inch scale here. To start with, it is a Pittman / Amtech. It's rated at factory at 24 volt DC, but in fact does run well at 12. We'll get into that in a moment. The full part number, see if I can get up there to show you, is GM9234E992-R1. Wonderful thing about surplus deals like this is usually you start off with an exact number, then halfway through you'll find out there's a few R2s or some other. But if those numbers are important to you, please call, let us know. We'll be happy to check and make sure we have that exact model number for you. Okay, it is factory spec'd at 24 volt DC at about 160 milliamp no load, 8 amp at full torque, but it does run well at 12 volt DC at 150 milliamps no load and about 4 amps stall. It does have a 5.9 to 1 gear ratio, and at 12 volts DC it's 525 RPMs, and at 24 volt DC about 1050 RPMs. Obviously a DC motor, it will vary depending on your load. It has two 1032 mounting holes on the front, and it has four 632s on the back. You hook up through a 17-inch wire lead coming off of it. Red, black, red's positive, black's negative. They have a 3-pin connector. Only use 2 of the pins. Sorry, we do not have the mating connector. Okay, we do have a mechanical spec on the motor itself, and I'll put up a screenshot of that here shortly. But we do not have any specs on the whole unit itself. This was custom made for somebody and we don't know what the original use was. But you can see standard 12-inch rulers. It's about almost 9 inches long. The last half inch is unthreaded, and it has a nylon traveler nut, which is about 1 inch thick. So you subtract that from the 8.5 and you get about 7.5 inch total travel area. The lead screw, we do say, is not removable, but there is a very small roll pin. If you have access to a quality machine shop, you probably could press it off and take off the lead screw, but really wouldn't recommend it. It's not that easy to do. Okay, now that we've seen this, give you a good visual. Okay, now for our storefront, we've made up this nice little contraption so people can play with it. I think it's a wonderful idea to see, you can see how it sounds, how it moves, the speed. Obviously, we're mounted to a board, we mount it to a bracket. We have it hooked up to a nice little 12 volt DC desktop power supply. So here we go. As you can see, just as is, it's going to need some kind of support to keep it because it just wiggles too much. But it is reversible. Put a little weight into it. You can see at 12 volts DC it does slow down somewhat. You can almost stop it, but still a fair amount of torque for a little device like this. Okay, that is our video. I hope you like it, enjoy it. I hope you understand the part a little better. Thank you for watching our video.